Let's do a quick just for fun segment in honor of Veterans Day, which is coming up. We said which SEC coach would fit in best with the military, or which coach would adapt the best to being in the military. Alternatively, which one would fit in the worst? Jesse, let's start with you.
I mean, I think
unless you're not ready.
No, I just go with my heart. Whatever comes out of my mouth. I don't think about this beforehand. I think Nick Saban would be the best for the military. He's obviously too old to actually join, but if he were of age, I think routine and discipline are very big on his list. So to me, he makes the most sense. I also could see Kirby Smart as like a Marine because he yells a lot and he's like super hyped. He could get in on that one, and they say like raw, and he barks a lot. So like maybe there's some stuff there. The worst. Oof. Honestly, I don't think Eli Drinkwitz has a chance.
Jesse keeps stealing all mine, damn it.
It would be rough. He would be like, do you mind if I have my own room? I brought a lot of books and they just don't fit in my cubby. And I don't see anyone liking him.
He would talk a big game, wouldn't he? Like a lot of Toughness Tuesday talk and we're going to do.
He's literally the guy that before he goes to basic, he tells everybody he's going to basic.
Right.
I'm going to basic. I'm going to be a blah, 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 blah. And it's like, bro, how are you going to be special forces? You haven't even gone to basic training. He's like, no. Toughness Tuesday. I'm at the recruiter's office every week. And it's like, why are you there every week? What are you doing? That's him. And then he gets there and everyone's like, bro, you didn't even make it off the bus without crying.
He's the guy who's a one-upper, but it's not his own stories. It's somebody else, one of his, you know, squad mates that he's telling stories about. Matt, who do you got?
Yeah, Jesse took all the ones I was thinking of, but Drinkwitz right off the bat's the one that probably would not fit in real well. He strikes me as too much of an academic, too much of a, you know, kind of like he's the kind of guy that just, and again, I'm going strictly off of what I've seen from the media. He seems like a big leather armchair reading a book and drinking like a glass of milk. He does not strike me as the type to be in the military. I think Kirby Smart would have to be in special forces. He seems so intense. I feel like he would be right there on the front lines doing everything he could. Sam Pittman and Mark Stoops would be in, but they would be your company sergeants that know how to get around all of the red tape and regulations. And if you need to get off base for something, you go see Sergeant Pittman or Sergeant Stoops. I get that vibe off of them.
1,000%.
Yeah. Gosh, it's tough. I think it would be just absolutely hilarious to see Kirby Smart as like a drill instructor and yelling at guys. That would be fantastic. I think probably overall, when it just comes to rigid militaristic style, I'd probably have to go with Saban. Just because that's just sort of what I think of. As far as who would be the worst, I can't imagine Lane Kiffin doing well in the military. He's just he's too renegade, right? He's too out there. He would never listen. He would want to do his own thing.
We should ask Lane, did you ever consider a career in the military? You got to let us know.
Yeah, that would have not gone well, I don't think.
They would have had him cut his hair. They would have had him cut his hair. He'd have to stop chasing girls on the side. Like, it's just
he would just have to go off base for that. But I mean, he's pretty regimented now from what I saw on game day. He's sober. He like gets up and does hot yoga every morning. Like,
the one thing that he cannot get over, and this is just really a part of who he is now, is the trolling online. He has not changed that at all. And I don't think it's going to. And as it, you know, it's just sort of is what it is now. So
I will say Billy Napier, because he looks like Jason Statham's cousin, might do well. He just has that face, that like no nonsense face. He's the guy that just like goes,
right. And you're like, you know, it's funny that you say that about the because I saw some Florida fans who have apparently started calling him the nickname Sling Blade. So, so there's that.
I'm not saying I couldn't see it. Oh no.
If you're looking at the online trolls, speaking of trolls, although that in that instance, it's your own fans trolling you. Anyway.
Hey, oh my God. He does look. Some people call it a Kaiser blade. I call it a sling blade.
He starts eating a lot of French fried taters.
Wow. You know who would be in the military, but it would be like the Navy, and it'd be on a submarine. Would be Brian Kelly.
Oh no, 100%.
It seems like he would be like a sub. You know, it's all about the family. In the submarine. So that just strikes me as.
You know who would have been great in the Navy?
Don't do that. Don't bring it up. Don't do it. We know.
Oh yes. Sorry. I would. Yeah. But well, a different Navy. The pirate. The alternative to the Navy.
That's fair.
So he's like, I don't need that Navy stuff. He's Mike's School of Pirating. So
if Mississippi State, if y'all don't build that. In memoriam,
for sure. Yep.
What about Hugh Freeze? Is Hugh Freeze involved in this at all? Nah, Hugh Freeze is a civilian.
Hugh Freeze tried to get in, and they looked at the charges pending against him for harassment.
Hey, he served his time on that, Jesse. Good Lord.
Just saying. They looked and they were like, oh, that's a liability.
While we're thinking about it, we haven't mentioned Beamer. How do we think that would have gone?
Not well.
I agree with you there.
Beamer would end up in the KP peeling potatoes literally every other day.
Okay. Hypo. He'd
be riding home and be like, Mom, can you just go pick me up?
Yes, I can see that. I can definitely see that, yeah.
Hypel kind of falls in that category with Pittman and Stoops. He's that sergeant that knows how to get out of trouble sort of situation.
That's right. Who's left? Oh yeah, Clark Lee. I think he'd do all right. It's just something about the baldness and the muscles that I think he'd probably be all right.
Yeah.
I think that's. Am I leaving anybody out?
Jimbo Fisher.
Jimbo and Arnett. Yeah.
Jimbo would not.
Arnett would be fine. He'd fit right in, I believe.
Jimbo strikes me as the kind of guy that would have paid for a replacement in the draft.
Yes.
He's a draft dodger.
I won't go that far. I feel like if it was like during the Civil War and they were calling people up, Jimbo would be like, here's my $2,000. You go find somebody else. I have other things to go do.
Right.
I have oil money to go spend.
Wow. All right. Well, that was a good one. I enjoyed that one.